How are you, man?
Yeah, good, good, good.
Yeah, you've become a Muslim or what?
When you explain to me the difference between Sidarat and Ahadu, then I'll consider it.
Can you? When you're afraid of green?
I don't think freedom of speech is something
I know that the Arabs, it's a degree. There's like degrees of it, aren't there? Like you have more freedom of speech here than you would if you were living in, I know, Nazi Germany.
I don't know, it depends what type of colour you are as well. Does that say a factor, religion or factor? If I was to say something, certain Muslims are to get up and say something, that's not freedom of speech, man. You know that, they'll get arrested.
But it depends what they say. Like there's, you're not allowed to incite violence. That's the, main thing. At the moment, like there's also like you're not allowed to call gross offence, for example. Like there was a guy who wrote a Facebook comment saying soldiers burn in hell or something, and that and he was prosecuted for that. And so I'm against that as well. And I want there to be the same freedom of speech as in America, basically. And I think if we had that kind of freedom of speech, it would be better than I know. That's the best form that we know of. Anyway, I think I'm going to get on a ladder. And
you're not spilling your hatred. It's fine. It needs to be banned.
What is your thing?
Well, why would the grown-ass man, it's not like you in your phone,
that grew up in the West, why would he be so obsessed to
one religion? That's why I really think to myself, man, like, come on, dude.
Well, I mean,
every Islamic Muslim person pissed you off like that, really?
No, it's not really like
this, this one religion got to you that much where you have to climb on stairs and be online for 5 hours and be like, Islam is a curse. I don't know.
Okay, when you ask the same question, for example, to people who come each week trying to refute atheism or agnosticism.
Actually, I find it more ridiculous.
Okay.
You know what I'm saying?
I haven't heard you sort of go up to, I know, Sabor and say, Sabor, come on, what is it? Why do you come each week trying to refute what you call Darwinism and atheism and liberalism?
I tell them why. I've even had conversations with them. I said, why do you always keep speaking to the same group of people that really
don't listen and don't really...
Okay. I've actually spoken. You've asked them.
Okay. Well, there's a couple of other reasons. One is that, like, I know, I feel like kind of there are lots of people who kind of don't have the same freedoms I do, and they would like to be able to freely say the things that are on their minds, the criticisms they have.
Is it only just in Muslim countries? I can name you certain some countries in South America, certain other countries that people don't really have their freedoms as well.
Yeah.
If we're going to be fair across the board.
Well, it is good to try and be fair, but also kind of, you know, there's a large number of problems to be solved in the world. Yeah. And like, I know, if I become, let's say, if I'm a skin doctor, you wouldn't go to a skin doctor and say, well, how come you aren't trying to cure cancer, you know? Because
we're not trying to cure anything, we're just trying to have an honest conversation.
Yeah.
When people get self-assessed with certain things and hate certain people, where does it become, like, for you, where does it become, I'm Muslim, where do we differentiate the line where you actually just hate Islam? You just hate people that believe in Islam.
So the whole thing that you're standing up and preaching, isn't that a bit of an oxymoron?
Like, are you preaching
the oxymoron?
Like, I hate this religion. Well, I know we're going to see you on the stairs. Islam. The whole day, you're going to be Islam.
Yeah.
Wild guess, right?
So wait,
I'm just saying, why are you going to be speaking about Islam?
What's the oxymoron?
I'm just saying, like, as a person that's saying, look, freedom for everyone, be a good person, all of that crap, isn't that a bit hypocritical? I don't know.
So what's the hypocrisy?
I'm just asking you, bro.
Well, I don't understand. If you can't put into words what the hypocrisy is, how can I defend it?
You have a good day.
You have a good day. Okay, let's get to the bottom of this, seriously.
Have a good day, man.
Hey, hold on, Nick. Okay, why don't you justify what you said? Okay, fine. Whatever. Yeah, sometimes people say kind of like, oh, the hypocrisy, and you just sneak the word in, and then you ask them what they mean, and they're like, oh, I don't know, bro, and then they walk away, and whatever.
James, you have a nice day anyway.
Yeah, you too.
I hope you enjoy your Sunday.
But maybe we can have a more sort of substantial conversation about this, where I actually hear what your points are, because at the moment
I'm going to watch you. Theory is going to be proven right.
But all that I heard was like, oxymoron, hypocrisy. And when I asked you for some explanation,
I apologize. Maybe I can't explain it right now, but I'm going to show you in camera what I mean. I'm going to show everyone.
Okay.
Go on your ladder. Let's see what you're going to be talking about.
All right.